Hi guys, this is Vaish from Vaish IAS, and hope you are enjoying the new series which we are doing, the R.S. Sharma series of ancient history, which is very much important for your prelims 2018. But I would recommend you to please watch class 6th videos of NCRT of history, which is already uploaded, because class 6th NCRT plus this thing is what you need to do, which is the minimum which you need to do for ancient history, okay? And I'm sure you'll not even miss a single question if you do this and then buy my MCQs and solve it, because around 225 MCQs are there available with us based on these textbooks alone, okay? So that will be an excellent revision for you, and you will not miss a question from ancient history. And the Facebook link is given here, where you have to contact me. You can use the message button there and then message me. I'll be there available, and you can ask me doubts or any other tips or guidance, and also get the MCQs by contacting there. The payment mode and all, I'll tell you there. It will be online payment anyway, and the PDFs will be given to you in email. Okay, soft copies. There is no hard copies as of now. So we'll begin. The PDF, you can just Google it and find it. It's there in online. Many sites are there. This particular PDF. So the fourth chapter is about the Stone Age. Okay, you know the Paleolithic, Mesolithic and Neolithic. We have done in detail in class 6th with different locations. We had zoomed into lot of locations. So here it's not much zooming in, but they have given small two-liner, three-liner, which is very, very, very important for the prelims as well as history optional students. Because history optional, you know, 50 marker question will come for just mapping. Okay, so you have to identify the location, the site, and then write a two-liner about it. It comes every year, 50 marks. Okay, 20 sites will be there, 2.5 marks, so 50 marks. So history optional students, this is a must-watch video. Okay, and also for those who are doing prelims. Anyway, everybody will be doing prelims. Okay, so Stone Age, if you see, a lot of pictures are there, but it's not so clear. Class 6th is better for pictures. Okay, then here we'll begin. India roughly from 5 lakh BC, okay, that is the time when they are telling humans existed. Okay, we used tools of unpolished, undressed, rough stones which have been found in South India and the Soan or Sohan River, that is in present day Pakistan. Okay, the Soan Valley, you will tell. So Paleolithic sites have also been discovered in Kashmir. So they're telling the extreme south, extreme north, okay, both places. The chips of stone were pebbles used for hunting, cutting and other purposes. In this period, man barely managed to gather his food and lived on hunting, okay, in the initial phase, they're telling 5 lakh years ago. So we had no knowledge of cultivation and house building. This phase generally continued till 8000 BC. okay, so till 8000 BC it will be like this. So that is the Paleolithic age. Actually, lot of websites teach you with lot of big tables with the split up of this BC, AD and timeline and all. That is all utter waste, because UPSC is never going to ask, and you don't need to do a PhD in these things. Okay, I don't know why they are teaching with lot of eras, epochs. They will tell this much year to that much year was dinosaur era, that much year was something else. That is all waste of time. Never it has been asked in UPSC. Okay, maybe 25-30 years back they would have asked, but that is not required. No. Now, so we'll see Paleolithic, you know, it is the old Stone Age, then there will be Mesolithic, then there will be Neolithic. Okay, in Paleolithic itself, based on the timeline, they will have just the earliest one, because it's 5 lakh years old, right? So the earliest one, then maybe the middle one and the new one. So just that much you need to remember. Paleolithic, Mesolithic, Neolithic is the broader one. Okay, later copper phase and all we'll see later. This is only the Stone Age. Okay, Stone Age, it is like Paleolithic, Mesolithic, Neolithic, and in the Paleolithic itself, because it's a huge thing, like from 5 lakh BC up till 8000 BC, that's a huge timeline, right? So because of that, they will just categorize it like early Paleolithic, middle Paleolithic and new Paleolithic, that's all. Other than that, no classification you need to know. Then tools they are telling, okay, have been found in the Chota Nagpur Plateau, and the timeline they are telling 25,000 BC to 10,000 BC. Don't buy hearted, but you should know old tools are found in Chota Nagpur Plateau. Then another place, Kurnool in Andhra Pradesh, okay. Kurnool in Andhra Pradesh. Then that is again important, because association with bone implements and animal remains have also been found. Okay, now you will be thinking like these many places, these many things, because I will be telling lot of things. How will you remember? So I already told you in my class 6th also, this is like a Excel sheet which I prepare. Okay, see this Excel. I don't know whether you can see it fully, but like this I maintain tables, and this table is not prepared one day at a time. Okay, it is done over days, over the years of preparation, over the months of preparation which you do. Okay, make Excel sheet, then one column should be Neolithic or Paleolithic, whatever it is, and according to that place the site names here. Okay, the exact site name and the state name, or if it's in Pakistan, write the country name, and then just keep on filling it. If you see what was the place you are discussing now, it was Kurnool. Okay, so Kurnool is somewhere here, it will be there, Andhra. Oh, I think it's Paleolithic, so it will be this side. Okay, so that and on left side everything was Neolithic. See here, Andhra, Kurnool, tools dated 25,000 BC, Paleolithic. So I made a note of this. Some other chapter, now I'll get some other information. I'll just come and fill it here. I'll put a comma here and I'll fill it. If you see this Maharashtra Inam Gav, this is not from a single textbook. It is from multiple textbooks. I have got it, okay. So whenever I study, whenever I see an MCQ, whenever I solve an MCQ here and there, I'll come and fill it. Then just before the day of prelims, I'll just look this one tab of Excel sheet and I'll get about hundreds of sites, okay. And I'll not miss even a single mark. So that is what you have to do. Now, many lazy aspirants who are watching this video, first thing they'll tell is, sir, please give me that Excel sheet. But if we are to do like this, then we are not meant for IAS, okay, IAS or IPS or whatever. We have to do the hard work. If we don't do these kind of note making, it's not like you have to copy paste this thing and do whatever I did. You can do your own note making, whether you are doing it digitally, you are doing it on paper, but it should be precise and it should be to the point so that you can clear it, okay. So true aspirant is one who do all these kind of hard work over the months, okay. Only they will clear this exam, that is my guarantee. UPSC is not like any other exam, like you study 5 books and go and you will pass it. You need a lot of hard work for it, okay. So let's get back. So this table I just wanted to show you. I am not going to read one by one. This is just to show you how you have to make notes. Okay. Neolithic, and I think below we'll have this Megalithic. See, Megalithic is there. This side Mesolithic is there. Mid Paleolithic. Like this and all. These are all information from multiple textbooks. So you also start preparing Excel sheet like this as and when you are hearing my lecture. Okay. Or just hear it once and then next time, one more time when you hear for revising, that time may open an Excel sheet and try filling it. Okay. So Kurnool in Andhra Pradesh, this bones and animal remains I told you. Then very important site is the Belan Valley in Mirzapur. Now we are talking only about Paleolithic, okay. Belan Valley in Mirzapur, that is in Uttar Pradesh. Okay, here goat, sheep and cattle were there. That means domestication of 25,000 BC was there, okay. Then Paleolithic phase, a man lived on hunting and gathering. Purana speak of people who lived on roots and fruits and some people living in the old way in the hills and caves. So that time everything was like hunting, and then this kind of bone implements, stone tools. So these are the general characteristics of Paleolithic, okay. Any site they ask, you can put all these things, okay. But most importantly, it is Kurnool and Belan Valley we have told in this paragraph. Now, the old stone age of Paleolithic culture of India developed in the Pleistocene period. These kind of periods also, they teach you hundreds of things in different websites. I have seen it. I don't know why they do it. Two names only you need to remember. One is Pleistocene and one is Holocene. Okay, Holocene is the one which we are living in now. Okay, now that is Holocene. The old one is Pleistocene. Two names alone you remember, nothing else you should remember. Okay. So Pleistocene and Holocene, I'll tell you more about that. So you see, Pleistocene period comes immediately before the geological period called Holocene or recent period in which we live. Okay, so this is recent and the other one is older one, that's all, which began about 10,000 years ago. We do not know when the Pleistocene period exactly began, okay, because that is very old one, we don't know when it began. Then again, Africa and all that telling something, we don't need it. The first human occupation suggested by stone tools, not earlier than middle Pleistocene. Again, middle, lower and all, I don't think it's important, but just remember the name, broader names, okay, Pleistocene and Holocene. Then phases in the Paleolithic age, I told you, right, the three things, the early or lower, then the middle, then the upper. Just remember the upper is the newer one, okay, upper is newer, then middle, then earlier. Don't need to remember the timeline and all, but this is how they just categorized it, because the tools and all will keep on changing when years pass by, that's all. So hand axes and cleavers were used initially. Axes found in India were more or less similar to those of Western Asia, Europe. So across the world it was almost same at that time. Okay, early Paleolithic, early Stone Age you can tell. And here again the Soan Punjab, you know, that is the 25,000 years ago, we saw it already. Soan Valley and Belan Valley again. So these are all old Paleolithic site, okay, very early ones. So hand axes have been seen then. That time it was kind of that Ice Age kind of thing. Try to watch the Ice Age animation cartoons. It is actually very good. Okay, animation movies, you will think it's very silly, but it shows actually the Ice Age and how the warm climate comes in, how the animals migrate. All those things are shown there. Okay. So Middle Stone Age is the next one. Again, it's like industry all based upon flakes, they tell. Okay. So flakes are found in different parts of India. The principal tools are varieties of scrappers made of flakes. Okay, again, stone, they'll chip it and make it like a blade kind of thing. So that kind of things were there in this Middle Stone Age. Okay, so it's like a little bit more improvising from the previous one, earlier ones, that's all. And here location, if you see, it'll be again Soan Valley, there again it was found. And then here I think river Narmada and Tungabhadra. Okay, that means in the south also it was there. So they're just explaining the improvisation happening in the early Paleolithic and the middle Paleolithic. Now the upper Paleolithic, lot of sites they have given. And here again it's like the Ice Age, right? The Ice Age is coming to an end. So comparatively the climate is becoming warmer. Okay, warmer and it will be less humid. So two terms, two characteristics, less humid and comparatively warm. The upper Paleolithic, okay, around timeline I'll tell you, it will be there somewhere down. Then again, see, for example, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Bhopal, so south, central, east, almost everywhere in India, it is there. And caves and rock shelters were there. One important thing is the Bhimbetka. Okay, Bhimbetka is in the Vindhya Hills in Bhopal or Madhya Pradesh, you can tell. That is upper Paleolithic site. It's very important. My Excel sheet also, it should be there somewhere. Okay, see here, MP, Bhimbetka, rock cave shelter. That is what I would have got from that paragraph. Some other paragraph I would have got more information. Okay, flint, hand axes, less humid. So it's new Paleolithic, upper one. Okay, so like this, try to make notes. Then again, flakes, blades, scrapers. Okay, tools are getting improved, that's all. Then humans which we see today, the we humans, okay, we actually started evolving at this time only. Okay, so the humans have been found from the new Paleolithic age. That is what they are telling. More, not like it's not there before that, but more of the present day form of human. Okay, they have been evolving in several stages, but the present day Homo sapiens first appeared in this particular age. Okay, so that you should know, upper Paleolithic. Bhimbetka cave also. Now, late Stone Age, you can tell. Again, same thing. So, time they are telling 8000 BC, Ice Age is coming to an end, climate is becoming warmer and dry. I told you that. Then, see left side, Mesolithic tools. Here also, if you see, two sites is there. Okay, there will be no explanation about this in this chapter, but you should note down these sites. Okay, some Birampur in West Bengal and some Tirunelveli of Tamil Nadu. Okay, so just make a note of this. Now, we don't have data, but in the Excel sheet, just make two columns for this. Later, somewhere we'll find something in some MCQ. That time will it. Okay, that's how we do. So, tools they are showing, like small stones they are showing. Okay, then climatic change brought about changes in fauna, flora, obviously that will happen. Humans, animals, plants, everything is getting changed. Then that is all about the Paleolithic. After that, next thing is Mesolithic. Okay, so Mesolithic age will come. It's a transitional phase between Paleolithic and Neolithic. That's also very simple to understand. Then again, 8000 BC to 4000 BC. You know, up to 8000 BC, it was that Paleolithic. Okay, the three phases of Paleolithic. After that, 4000 years, it is the Mesolithic. Okay, then characteristic tools of the late Stone Age are microliths. Okay, the late Stone Age sites are found in good numbers in Chota Nagpur, Central India and South of River Krishna. So, that also almost everywhere. Okay, they're talking about the Neolithic now. Mesolithic, Neolithic, both. Then, Vindians in Balen Valley. So this Balen Valley, if you see all three phases, it's there. Okay, because they have been getting tools, discovering tools which has different timeline when they do that analysis, whether radiocarbon dating or the pollen analysis. They have a lot of things which we discussed in chapter 1. So they will get to know the different timeline of different tools, and they came to know like Balen Valley has almost everything. Okay, see, these are different examples. Okay, Neolithic also, one thing you have to know is tools became polished. Okay, more and more polished tools are used in the Neolithic. It is mentioned here. Okay, polished stone. So again, they had all kind of tools. Then let me see what is important here. Burza home. In class 6, I did a very detailing explanation of this site. Okay, here again they are doing that. Okay, there are pictures also over there. So please watch that. Here if you see the Burza pit dwelling. People used to live in pits. Okay, they used to have steps which will go down, and that is a plateau in pits. And they had this hunting and fishing economy. Then they had this thing. They were not acquainted with agriculture or domestication of animals. There were animals, few of them, because it is told like dogs were actually buried along with them in the pit. Okay, it will be there somewhere here only. So obviously domestic animals they knew, but it was not like goats, sheep, cattle and all, they did not know. But it was a hunting and fishing economy. Okay, so polished tools were there, bone implements were there. Next, Chirind is a site. It's actually in Bihar, okay, near Patna. So that is next Neolithic site. Okay, so Burzahom, Chiranda, Neolithic sites. This also will be there in my Excel. So here again, 100 centimeter rainfall, that is not very important, but bone implements were found. Okay, these kind of key features, try to make a note. Chirind, Bihar, bone implements. Now, people of Burzahom had coarse grey pottery. This is also feature, coarse grey pottery, because pottery changes when civilization changes. Okay, then again, see, dogs were buried with the masters, pit dwelling was there. Then Burzahom 2400 BC, that is the dates they found the bones and all. Okay, Chirand and Burzahom, both places bones were there, bone implements. Then again, they're telling this Chirand is little more newer, that is the stone copper. Next phase will be copper phase. Okay, so Chirand was a little bit extended to that phase also. That's what they're telling. Okay. Next is the second group of Neolithic people lived in South India. That is in, now we talked about Burzahom and Chirind. Now they're going south of the Godavari. There also there were people living on the hills. So this is one important map. But more clearer map is in class 6. Please watch that. Okay. If you want, you pause and see all the sites, Neolithic sites are there. It's very, very, very important for history optional students. This is the source from where you have to study. UPSC every year asks 20 sites. Okay, every year. So please prepare for that. Next is, the Godavari region we are discussing. So there, stone blades were there, baked earth figurines were there, then cattle is there, rubbing stone quarries. So rice, the grains, art of producing grains and all they knew. Okay, the Godavari region they are telling. Then again, next slide they are telling about the Assam, the Garo Hills in Meghalaya and all. There also a lot of things have been found because of like dating. It's not so clear. They don't know the clear date, but they have discovered lot of tools and these kind of stone equipments there. Okay, so they know like there also stone age sites were there. Again, Mirzapur, Vindhyas, they are telling, which we already discussed. Then this is all important places. Okay, we don't have description here, but you should make columns. Okay, like in Excel if you are doing Maski, Brahmagiri, Hallur, Kodaikal, Sanganakallu, Narsipur, and the Takalakota. These all are in Karnataka, every place in Karnataka. Okay, and Payyambali is in Tamil Nadu, and Piklihalli and Utnur are in Andhra Pradesh. All these are Neolithic sites in South India. Okay, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh. In the map also it would have been there. And watch the class 6 if you want more information. The Neolithic settlers in Piklihal, so see here we saw Piklihal, and if you have made an Excel, you can get more details from this next paragraph. So that is how you fill it. Okay, I think I would have done it already. It is Neolithic, right? Neolithic site, Andhra, Karnataka. See, Karnataka, I have made these columns. Piklihal, I got information, so I filled it. Others I did not get. Whenever I get MCQs or some data, I fill it. Okay, that's how you should work. And here you should fill Neolithic, okay? Like this, you should fill Neolithic. Okay. So Piklihal cattle herders, seasonal camps, they had this shifting cultivation kind of thing. Okay, they'll set on fire, okay, the entire camping ground they'll put on fire and then go away. Next season they'll again come back. Okay, that kind of thing they had, Piklihal, and they accumulated cow dung. So these are few features about Piklihal. This is what exactly when UPSC asks you to mark the site and tell, you have to tell. Okay, the later Neolithic sites were agriculturalist, okay, and they lived in circular or rectangular houses. That is the later Neolithic, okay, and they produced ragi and horse gram. Horse gram was called kulathi. So in case they ask kulathi, what is it my meaning in the this context, then you have to tell this it's a horse gram. Okay, so again Neolithic, they had this food grain, milk, and they are evolving. Okay, foot wheels were there. So discovery is happening and Neolithic is kind of little more flourishing and adapting towards the modern world. Now 9000 BC to 3000 BC, they are telling the most remarkable process where technology evolved, the domestication of animals, the cultivation of crops, people settling down, all these things happened between this time. Okay, that is the kind of you can tell Mesolithic age onwards. Paleolithic was kind of a nomads kind of thing, hunting and fishing. And the people of the Stone Age suffered from one great limitation. Since they had to depend upon tools made of stone, they could not find settlements far away from the hilly area. So because they need that big stones, right, they always settled in the hilly regions only. They did not go to the plains at that time. That is why it started everything in the mountainous region. Later only we will see kingdoms are coming in the Ganga Valley. Okay, first and all, everyone are there in the hills only. Further, even with great effort, they could not produce more than what they needed for bare subsistence. Okay, so they could produce only what they needed for eating. They could not do a extensive cultivation or agriculture kind of thing. That is also very important. Now pause this and see these questions. Next we will see the MCQs. Okay, the earliest paintings discovered is from which period? This actually is not there in this chapter, but I want you to think and tell me. It is very easy if you think. You have to tell me which phase. Sorry, you have to tell me which phase paintings were there. Okay, so Paleolithic, Mesolithic, Neolithic or Post-Neolithic is, tell me in comment section. Even if it is wrong, I will tell you the correct answer, but please attempt. Okay, this is what UPSC will do. They will ask these kind of questions. The most spectacular rock shelter in India, the Bhimbetka, is located at. It's a very easy question, I discussed in this chapter also, so try to answer. Okay, question number 3 and question number 4. Now last question for today is identify the site. Okay, UPSC used to do this. They'll give some this thing and you have to identify, or they'll do reverse. They'll give this answer directly in the question and then put 5 statements and tell like 1 and 2, 2 and 3, 2 and 4. So here if you see, it's easier. Okay, because all the 6 points are true and all 6 points are given to you and you have to just tell the site name. They can do it reverse also. So you should study all these things. Tell me in comment section which is this. It's already discussed and it's a very easy question, so please do it. And this is my Facebook page. Every day we are posting 5 questions. PDF of the entire thing, about 225 questions of ancient history, you can buy from us. These kind of questions will be there. You can easily practice. Any donation you want to make, because we also want to grow, we also want resources and funds and all. So if you can donate something, you can donate to this particular number, Paytm. And then MCQs also, payment will be through Paytm or online, okay, bank account. So if you practice the right way, no one can stop you from cracking UPSC this time. That is our logo and we all should clear prelims, okay, 2018. Okay, so I'll come up with the next video soon. Till then, give your feedback, enjoy your learning. Thank you and have a nice day.